Good morning. You're listening to FloridaAlley.net, and I'm Kemp Parr. This morning, my guest is Tom Levi, a founder of Levi's for Floors based in Columbus, Ohio. Tom, how you doing?
Real good, Kemp.
I understand you had a birthday the other day, so happy birthday. It's a nice big round one for you, right?
I'm not getting any younger. Of course, none of us are, but boy, I'm pushing the limit, I think, on this one.
You're still passionate. That's why I want to talk to you.
Hey, hopefully my mind doesn't change and it'll keep working. So yeah. That's what I'm driving at.
All right. Well, let me just give our listener a little bit more about you. You're a top 100 retailer. You've got 5 stores under the Levi for Floors brand name, which is also, mm-hmm. you're an NFA member there. And you've got 2 stores under the Carpet One brand name in that Columbus area. And you've got a son who's kind of stepped in. His name's Tyler. You've been transitioning some of the day-to-day decisions to him, haven't you?
Oh, a lot of them have been transferred to Tyler. I'm still coming in 10 hours a day, it seems like, especially this year. But yeah. I'm looking forward to slowing down, to be honest with you.
This has been a crazy year with the COVID, but a big part of your business is residential replacement, and you're actually going to probably end up growing this year, aren't you?
We are blessed that I think we're having an excellent year considering the mix of business. As you know, we do some custom builder work, but we don't chase that spec builder work or that low new home construction. We do a lot of custom builder work, but not the track building business.
Well, you've been a go-to person for the industry. Many of the leaders, you know, I know Julian Saul, I know Bob Shaw, all, you know, call you and ask you what's been going on. You've been a big advocate. Actually, if you look at your website, you've got the Stainmaster Flooring Center logo at the top of it. So carpet's still a big part of what you sell, isn't it?
It's still the majority of what we sell, yes, sir. We have goals that we set every year for what percentage of what categories we're going to do. And our business model has been that way, Kemp, since the late 80s, early 90s.
I did an interview with Jeff Mocco the other day, and it's been all over social media. And I wanted to do this interview with you as well because you continue to have your RSAs push nylon products. Tell us about that, if you would.
Well, I mean, our model has been to sell what we believe is the most style and fashion product out there that has performance or warranties in place, whether they're proprietary or whether they're general warranties, that assure the customer that they're buying one of the finest pieces of products made with the finest material made.
Yeah.
And our belief has always been, it goes back as far as when we had to mix of staple and filament type 6/6 nylon, in our belief, offers the best flexibility for style and fashion manufacturing, as well as performance and cleanability of both products out there. Now, we're seeing some changes over the years. I think that Mohawk did a job of their Tri-X and Silk, especially.
Yeah.
We maintain records on that, but our nylon business, we target every year to be at least 70% of our business. This year, I think through the end of Q3, I think we were 68% in nylon.
Okay.
So we're a believer of it.
It seems almost like logical sales process to say, if you think about carpet and you think about what's sold in the commercial side of the business, it's almost all nylons. That's because it holds up, and it's because you can able to style with it, and it'll keep the patterns, and it'll give you a high-low and be resilient. So if that's what the commercial market's buying, which has more wear and demand on it, why wouldn't you want to put that in your home as well? Isn't that part of the message?
That's been our belief since literally 85, 86. What we want to do is to drive what we call a legacy customer.
Right.
And to drive legacy customers, transparency, supplying them with the best of everything and the best warranties or the best knowledge for them to make a decision, we believe is of the utmost importance. Our regular retail sales associates, I think our average right now has been with us 18 years. They've been taught in this policy for their entire careers here. And we have customers that 7-8 purchases over the last 20 years. Mm-hmm. Grandchildren are buying from us today. It makes a difference. I think the biggest difference here is that's afforded us the ability to keep our sales in soft surface up to that level of closer to a 65% total revenue percentage than what we would be typically seeing with the LVT and the WPC growth that we've seen the last 5-6 years.
Isn't it a differentiator, too, when you start thinking about the home centers and what Levi's for Floors offers versus the home centers? I mean, it's a differentiator. You sell better in goods, and you can go to a home center and you can get the other stuff, right?
Well, don't kid yourself. We believe that the home centers are selling, or I shouldn't say selling. We believe the customer doesn't get sold there where they buy there.
Yeah.
But through POP, through the merchandising that Stainmaster themselves do, or Invista himself does at home centers. We think that's been one of the major changes, the reasons that we had to change our mix. You know, I don't mind telling you, Kemp, and I think you probably realize this. Years ago, we'd talk and 80-90% of my business was Stainmaster fiber. Today, that's not the case. I don't want anybody to think we do a tremendous amount of nylon business. But understand something, I think it's appalling to take the brand, because I've been a steward of that brand for over two decades, literally mask it with polyester products, mask it with unbranded nylon products and stuff like that. So I'm out here building a brand, or built a brand for two decades on Stainmaster, and I got Lowe's that keeps running with it. So be it. I mean, we'll live with it. We don't back off of competition. I mean, we welcome it sometimes.
Right. A lot of times it's about the density, too. I mean, I don't think you're getting the same density over there at the home center, are you?
No. Our average weight across the board through Q3, it was 57.5 ounces this year. Uh-huh. Now, at that point in time when the industry is averaging 30-some-odd probably ounces, that makes a huge difference in your average retail selling price. That has afforded us to do certain things with the shortage of installers, certain things with the kind of revenue dollars you can drive per unit. So all of that's helped, I think, grow our business. We're definitely not selling a hell of a lot more volume carpet per foot or per yardage, but we can grow the revenue dollars between that and the hard surface growth, and that's been our strategy for every year since 2012, I should say.
All right, let me one other quick thing I want to talk about. I'm looking at your website. It's a gorgeous website. I see you're still using Creating Your Space, and I know probably Tyler's making that decision. You also are doing some traditional advertising. You continue to do traditional advertising, and it's made a difference, right?
It made a wonderful difference this year, I can tell you that. It was kind of unusual. You know, we saw literally not just in our industry, and unfortunately it was across the board in that March COVID began.
Yeah, right.
The cancellation of tremendous amounts of advertising on a national basis, and rightfully so. I mean, people didn't know what was going on.
Right.
We decided to gamble, because we're blessed with a very strong balance sheet, that we would leverage our assets in a time of stress to make our brand stronger within the marketplace at hopefully a less unit cost. We 2.5 times our budget and absolutely quadrupled the amount of exposure we've got from advertising in April, May, and June, and the numbers just followed the advertising, basically. And that was not only just traditional advertising, but it was also in what we did with our website from a standpoint of exposure on it, working with Google Direct and the Google Analytics, that made a huge difference. Our cost per point on advertising dropped from last year at $108 down to $32. So when you do that and you're doing 700-800 spot a month in TV alone, you get some results.
All right, well, that's good to know. So you had a birthday. How much longer are you going to do this, Tom?
Well, I don't know. The weather's bad right now, so I have to wait a little while.
Yeah,
you know, I do go to Florida. I would assume if I could get through this year and feel comfortable, I'm very comfortable turning everything over and basically helping out wherever they need me to help out. John and I'm in my 70s now, and John's reaching it, so we're ready to slow down.
Okay, Tom, thanks so much for spending time with us. Great to catch up with you again. Been talking to Tom Levi, the founder of Levi's for Floors, with 7 stores in the Columbus, Ohio area, and you've been listening to Kempar and FloridaDaily.net.